dystopian. Oh, wait, sorry. Wrong video. Welcome to a part unboxing and part test footage, photos, whatever. Where I'll be unboxing the new camera gear that I acquired, not just for my YouTube channel, but also just as equally as important for filming wildlife. I'm currently recording with the Panasonic GH5, which I acquired last year, 2021, and I thought that's going to be it, the last time I need to upgrade, because I don't really film much outside of the house. Most of my videos are done here in the basement, and so, you know, I upgraded from the Panasonic GH4, which is here, and I dropped at least once, which is why this looks, you can see the flash there, looks banged up. I'll just, hopefully the camera can focus in on that. It has a macro lens attached. My GH5 is set to autofocus, which I don't use that much because it's kind of quiet, but microphones that I use, and when I make these ASMR videos, I boost I'm speaking at pretty much line level at like negative 50 or negative 40 dB, and I always have to raise the volume up in post by about 23 decibels. So sometimes it'll pick up the autofocus noise from the Panasonic GH5, but anyway. So I wasn't planning on doing this video, acquiring this gear, until a few weeks ago when I forget how, but I learned that the Sony put out the A7 IV, and I heard about the A7 III, but by that time I already invested in Panasonic, the digital cameras and the lenses, so I wasn't going to make the switch. I don't really think I needed to. I'm very happy with the quality of the videos that I put out for the most part, and I don't really shoot in vlog or anything like that, but I found out the A7 IV came out, and then the next thing I know, one thing led to another, and I'm looking into zoom lenses, the 100 to 400 focal length lenses. I never owned one of those before, and I thought, well, Panasonic makes one, but I know the GH series of cameras don't have a great autofocus, which you need, because I was thinking about getting into filming, at least maybe photographing wildlife, birds, whatever, squirrels, chipmunks, and so on. And that's why I was looking into these zoom lenses, and I just was thinking, you know, well, I don't know if I want to, maybe I should switch now and upgrade to, you know, move to Sony or Canon. So just after, you know, toiling, analyzing, you know, I decided to go with Sony. So, yeah. So I've been using the GH4 since about when that came out. What was that, 2015? Prior to that, the first 500 videos or so on my channel, starting back around 2011, were shot with a camcorder. And you'll probably notice the quality. Not this one, I think it might have been a Panasonic camcorder. And of course, back around 2011, I don't think the consumer or prosumer video cameras had good quality video at that time. And then I eventually made the leap to the GH4. Oh, and prior to the digital camcorder that I used for my channel, this is the first camcorder I pretty much ever owned. It's a mini DV camcorder. It uses mini DV cassettes. This was mostly used for home video. I've never used it for the channel because obviously it's an analog and a lot of work to transfer from a cassette to a computer. But this is the camera that I use to make the some of the, that you might have seen in some of my videos, unless you're new here, that I like for the camera sounds. I could do that for hours, but I don't want this video to be too long. I'm gonna do the unboxing now. And then it's been raining here last couple of days. By the time I put this video together, hopefully I'll have captured some footage of the different wildlife, because that's really why I acquired this. My interests are dwindling. I've been a gamer most of my life, and playing video games, that comes and goes. My interest in movies, A24 Studios has really ruined movies for me. Midsommar, The Black Coat's Daughter, Hereditary, Lamb, those are like some of the best movies I've ever seen, far better than Alien. Well, Alien is right up there. But, okay, so let's get on with it. I'm really looking forward to just getting outdoors and just enjoying those, a day, once a week, or hopefully more, it depends. And photographing the wildlife and making a video, at least one video, a year, where I kind of talk like this, or soft-spoken, whatever, and like a documentary, kind of like what I did with my macro photography. So, all right, so let's start with... this unboxing. But, and I'd like to ask you, not sure if you're here because you are into photography or videography yourself, or just here to relax, whatever. Either way, it's cool, of course. But, I've never owned a large zoom lens, and I'm kind of intimidated by that. I won't lie, but we'll get to that in a moment. All right, let's open this up. So I can't see if that's focusing or not, but I hope so. Okay. We have a little pamphlet about all the different Sony lenses and accessories. Okay, we have maybe another, different language of the says here, interchangeable lens, digital camera, another small little quick reference guide, I guess. You can see that. Hopefully that focused. I'll stop saying that. Let's see, we have something about the capture cards. Notice of replacement program for some SD memory cards of the certain series. Okay, it briefly states here that could be some memory errors when using certain cards. Okay. Chance to win a prepaid card. Warranty. Okay, now to the stuff, let's see. Camera strap. There's a ring in here. Let me just open this up. No, it's not a ring. It is a USB-C. I'm at one end, and then USB. I guess at the other. So, transfer files, live stream, maybe. Okay. in a cloth little pouch like this. It's a USB, a wall wart plug to, I guess, charge the camera, or at least, you know, operate it, charge it from an outlet, or maybe even operate it while it's plugged in. We have another cloth pouch. Also in a cloth pouch. And sorry, maybe I should have shown you everything in the box first. For curiosity's sake, I guess, before I took everything out, but that's it. Let me set this aside. Say I like the way they packaged it. Different. And there we have it. A7 IV, hopefully that will focus. Take a look at it, just in case you haven't seen it close up. Okay, of course we have a cover for where you would attach the lenses. In case you don't have a lens attached, use this cover, keep out dust, etc. The one thing I wasn't sure about when figuring out if I wanted to acquire this camera was if it had a flip-out LCD. Because right now I'm filming with my GH5. It has a flippy LCD that I can turn to face towards me. So out of the corner of my eye, I know I'm still recording and where I am on the camera and where I am in the frame, in the shot. So let's see. This has a flip out. There we go. And it faces forward. Okay, that's perfect. That's all I need. Of course, very useful for when you're outdoors and you need to film or photograph in a weird angle like that. You can still see up top or down low, photographing the other ground. You don't have to get down onto the ground, if you're looking for some low shots. So around a corner, you never know, but this is good. Flip out screen. And let's just show you how similar it is to the Panasonic GH4. Again, I'm filming with the GH5. Most cameras are very similar. Some minor differences here and there, but so nothing too out of the ordinary or too different. A couple extra dials here, it looks like. So, yeah. Looks like we have a few different function buttons. Record button, on off, different dials for shutter, ISO, I assume, different mode here, I guess, shutter priority, manual. Hopefully, take a look at that. Camera will focus. Does it tingle? Not much real estate to work with. Say about the cover. So you'll have to be the judge of that, but all right. Okay, and of course, put the battery. Slot and an arrow indicating which way. Okay, there we go. I don't think the battery is charged, but let's see, I can turn it on. Yeah, there's nothing, so, okay. All right, so is the A74. Just once again, take a look at that. Right, in case you've never seen one, or you're looking to acquire one yourself. Okay, so put that aside. Now, because I'm switching from a Micro Four Thirds to a full frame, I have to get new lenses, and one of the lenses I have to get for regular video shooting is a minimum of a 24 millimeter lens, which gives me the, right now I'm using on my GH5 Micro Four Thirds an 18, I think it's an 18 to 35, which equates to 24 to 70, 12 to 35, something like that. Anyway, whatever. So the equivalent, I believe, hopefully I purchased the right lens, is this FE 24 to 70 millimeters. So this is the other lens that I needed to acquire so I could do my regular YouTube videos or just any other video where I don't need such a long zoom. So let's open this up. Looks like a bunch of manuals and warranties in here. That's it for the box. Set that aside. So this is nice. It comes in its own case. I wasn't expecting that. Let's open this up as quietly as possible, but I may have to edit all this out. Okay, I don't have to tear it open. That's nice. Thank you. set that aside. All right, we have a strap for the lens. Looks like we have a, I forget, a lens hood. Yeah. Not so much a protective hood. I mean, that's at the end of the camera. This is more to keep out the sun directly hitting the lens. See that? Hopefully. It's noisy. Okay. Alright. So here is the 24-70. The lens that I have on the GH5. It's about like that. So it's half. I'd say it's about half the length. Hopefully you can see that. Looks like we have. That's the zoom. Focus, manual focus, switch, a lock, focus lock, maybe zoom, I don't know. Okay, so that's what I'm gonna need for my filming every day. See that? Okay. Okay, so that's the lens that I'm going to need for every day. Filming for my channel. Very big lens. Somewhat heavy. So, okay, now for the heavy hitter. Let me just make some room. Oh, and real quick, I also picked up a dual charger so I can charge both batteries at the same time. Thank you. minutes recorded so far. I was hoping I could do this unboxing in about half an hour. Here is the extra battery that I picked up. Camouflage lens cover for the 200 to 600 zoom lens so it doesn't stick out like a sore thumb, a little more, less conspicuous. When I was originally deciding whether to move to Sony or Canon, I was researching the 100 to 400 zoom lenses, and Canon has a 100 to 400, and I know there's Tamron and Sigma, but then I found out about the 200 to 600 by Sony, and yes, it's double the price of the Sigma or Tamron, but it has really good sharpness and autofocus, and of course it's made by Sony, so less problems or issues with autofocus compared to using a Tamron or a Sigma on a Canon or even on a Sony. And this is really why I acquired the A7IV, you know, in addition to hopefully being a better upgrade to the GH5, because I really want to get into wildlife photography with a really good zoom lens. Now this is a 200 to 600. I was considering the 100 to 400, but knowing that I'll be trying to film or photograph birds, things that are far out of reach, bats flying overhead, hawks, I'm rarely going to be at the 100, and I'm not into sports or landscape that much. So 200 seems like a good minimum, and a reach all the way to 600. And then being able to shoot in 4K on the A7IV and have that ability to enlarge that to 1080p, that's, you know, double the zoom right there as well. That's why I went with the Sony 200 to 600 for the reach. It's Sony, made by Sony. Sharpness, all that. Okay, let's open this up. Alright, so we have looks like a lens case. It's folded in half. Aside. Another lens strap. And I wish I could do those sounds more often, but it's bad enough this video is almost an hour. It's going to be at least, 50 minutes or so. And I haven't even, gotten any of the photography or anything yet. More noisy cardboard. Another plastic bag with the manuals and whatnot. Something over here, to the right, your left. Hood. Let's take that out. Itself. See if that triggers your ASMR, or if you at least find it a pleasant sound. I can only hold this up like this for so long. Awkward. Let's get rid of the bubble wrap. raises, so it's the whole reason why I upgraded from a GH5. Take a look. Hopefully. Tripod mount right there, which comes off. Here are the numbers that show you what focal length you're at. And then over here, a bunch of different switches for autofocus, manual focus, and other things related to the lens. Not sure what that is, that knob. I think this might be something. Oh. Probably for autofocus or something. Okay. And yeah, so let's take off the front cover. Not scratched or anything. Nice lens there. See if I can, if you can see that reflection at all. So we have the zoom, which is internal. There's nothing being extended, and it goes from 200 to 600 like that. Just a, not even a full rotation. These up somehow. There's no, oh, there we go. There's there's a little white dot there and a white dot on them. Gently as possible. Twist and a click. And there we have it. Not sure. Don't think I want to hold it just by the camera body. So I'm going to have to probably remove the foot. Take this off. Looks like it comes off easy enough. Out. Luckily, I'm still in the 30-day return period if I need to return it. I'm hoping not. I'm really hoping this isn't going to, you know, invigorate me, get me another interest, get me outdoors, another hobby, pastime, and then, you know, and all that. So, all right. So there it is, the Sony A7 IV and the 200-600. And that's going to do it for the unboxing. I'm going to charge everything up and then take this out. Hopefully capture some decent footage and test photos and footage. And that will be the rest of the video. Okay, so I took the camera and lens out on two different days at two different locations, and I have to say, not only am I thrilled and very happy, but the Sony A7 IV, which I am filming with now using the 24-70mm lens combined with the 200-600, makes me look like a good photographer. I mean, really, I'm just a biomechanical tripod. I just stand there, try to find the bird or critter, animal, whatever, and then try to remain still, and then just push the buttons, and then everything else does all the work. No, but seriously, just real quick, this is the cover that I showed in the unboxing, which goes over the lens. There's about 8 different pieces that you have to slide on. And like I said before, it's not just good for making a little less conspicuous, so it's not this, you know, giant bright white lens, kind of, you know, hides it from the wildlife a little bit, but it, of course, it also helps against, you know, protect it from scratches and dings and, you know, dirt and all that. On both of my outings, I was at 600, the full focal length, for 95% of the time. There was one or two times when I either was very close to a bird or there was a large bird where I had to zoom out. But other than that, I was at the 600 range the entire time. So this Sony 200-600 has its own stabilization. It has three modes. Standard, I forget what mode 2 is, and then mode 3. That's one of the switches here that I kind of showed a close-up look in the during the unboxing. The stabilization combined with the Sony A7IV, I think was really good. You'll see in some of the images, I was able to capture some images that I was more than happy with at a high shutter of about 1/2500th of a second, or 1/2000th, something like that, to freeze birds in flight and all that, to minimize movement, motion blur. As long as I come back with some photos that are not completely blurry, you know, even there's just a little bit, that's fine, as long as I can see the details, because that's really what all this is. You know, not just getting me outdoors, you know, but I don't know how to relax. I need to do something. And video games and movies, you know, they're okay. But winter time, fall, summer, I'm fascinated with wildlife. Birds, bugs, squirrels, it doesn't matter. And being able to finally, you know, get back to one of my passions. I mean, I'm not going to ditch my ASMR videos, you know, so don't worry about that. But I need this. I absolutely love being outdoors and trying to capture some intimate moments that you just can't see with the naked eye. That's why, you know, I love the macro, and then of course the long lens, like having a microscope out in the wild. So I was able to handle this. It's just around 5 pounds, but there is some fatigue when you're trying to hold it. You know, you have to brace your arms against your body. But I am in the process of acquiring a monopod just so I can rest my arms and for the added stability when taking photos. Now, the video, which I want to get into, I definitely need a tripod for that. Okay, so let's take a look at some of the photos I was able to capture. First up, we have an American robin, and it just got done trying to find a bug or a worm in the dirt. I don't really know what is in its mouth. A little blurry right here, but again, I'm kneeling down on the ground, and at I think I was at the full 600 millimeter length. I'm not sure what my shutter speed was at. This was the very first day that I was using the 200 to 600, but I'm very happy with the photo. This is a crop. The original photo is much bigger. Next, we have maybe a family or friends, I don't really know, of bluebirds. And this is a crop, about half of a crop of the original photo. And you can just see the sharpness and clarity. And this is exactly why I love the long lens, because these are the types of details that you can see that you wouldn't be able to do with the naked eye, maybe with binoculars. Here is the original photo, not a crop, of a bluebird with, to take a closer look, and you'll see it has some kind of caterpillar in its beak. And this particular bluebird, it was holding on to this worm all this time. I was photographing these bluebirds for about 5 or 10 minutes, and I think there's some young bluebirds in this box. I just feel like, you know, why didn't the bluebird eat the worm? You know, I'm thinking it's to feed its young, but I don't know. Here is a 600 millimeter. Again, all these images are at, most of them, 600 millimeters. This is a, I don't know if they call it a northern cardinal, but the typical you'll find here around the Mid-Atlantic region. This was very far away. Again, handheld, you know, not too sharp. It's about a 3/4 crop. And, you know, I'm very happy with this image as it is. I just love the cardinals and just, you know, the red bird that you don't often see. I believe this is a cat bird. So again, a little bit of sharpness was added in post, just about 20 points of sharpness, not much. But just look at the, I mean, this is what I love, being able to see, capture the details of the bird and the eye. So I'm again, just happy as a cat bird sitting on a branch being photographed by a human being. And even its little feet, little bird feet there. And this was this is like a 16th of a crop. The entire image here has the bird in the very towards the bottom because I'm hand holding and trying to be, you know, using the stabilization. It's flying around, so I'm not sure exactly what bird yet. I still have to. I'm not the expert when it comes to all the different types of birds. But you know, this isn't. I'm very happy with this image right there, given that the original image was much smaller. How far away the bird is. So me being able to capture this particular bird for the first time in my life, I'm, you know, more than thrilled. Here are, I looked up the name of these birds and I forget them. Again, I was able to capture some, you know, this is a small crop. This is about 1/4 of a crop of the original image. You can see some sharpness has been added. But I'm, again, just another kind of, you know, one of those moments I was able to capture. And I'm very happy to be able to have captured that. These are the types of things that I'm looking, trying to capture. And this is a great blue heron, I think is what it's called. And of course it's flying away. Not the most ideal photo to capture, but sometimes you just have to, you know, take what you can get. So, you know, not the most clear photo, but again, this is a very small crop. This is about an 1/8 crop or so of the full image, which was much larger. So, you know, if that's ever the only image that I have ever captured of a great blue heron, I'm more than happy to have captured that. I think this might be an egret, but don't take my word for it. I just want to say that name. I think this is the full original picture. Let's just zoom in here. Of course, we have the feet. Not bad. Now, this was taken at 1/60th of a second shutter speed. Not the shutter speed you want to take a picture with, because I was moving between video and photo all throughout the day. And I had to, when you move to video on the Sony a7 IV, you have to reset your shutter speed. But, you know, not bad for 1/60th of a second. Fortunately, it was a bright day. This kind of shows you, I guess you could say this is a testament to hand-holding the 200-600 with its own stabilization and the stabilization of the Sony a7 IV, which I think was on standard. Not the most ideal photo because some of the bird, the highlights, the back is blown out. So I forgot to compensate for exposure. But, you know, my goal was to test out the camera and the lens and see if I could get some decent shots. You know, that's good enough for me. Like I said, if I never get a shot like this of this particular bird species. The rest of my life, I'll be more than happy to have captured this one. And that's pretty much my attitude when I go out there, just try to capture what I can. Also, when you hold down the shutter and it takes multiple photos, one after the other, that was great too. So again, here is the same bird flying off of that bird box, and this is at 1/60th. It took me a while, it took me about 15 minutes or so before I realized I was shooting at 1/60th of a second instead of 1/2000th, which would have frozen the wings. But you know, this is not too bad because it kind of shows the movement. And here is a blackbird, red-winged blackbird, I think they call them. Absolutely love these birds. I love all the different types of wildlife, but I just love the black with the little stripe of red. Again, just very pleased with the sharpness and the details. Now I can finally zoom in and see. You know, it's not just a red stripe. You know, there's some other color there. And then the last photo is just a picture of where I was one of the days. I was at a place called the John Hines, well, obviously, the John Hines National Wildlife Refuge at Tinicum, which is just about a 5-minute drive from the Philadelphia airport. So if you're ever coming to Philadelphia, you have to come to John Hines Wildlife Refuge because it's a wetland area, and any kind of bird that you'll find in the Mid-Atlantic region, especially in Pennsylvania, you'll find at the John Hines. And if you don't have access, you know, to a something like this where you live, you know, hopefully there's some kind of park or something that you can get to try to find some of the wildlife in your area. And so that's it for the photos. If you're interested, I opened up a new Instagram account. Hopefully this is the last time. So you can find me on Instagram at ephemeral.rift. And you can also find me on Flickr. And of course I have a website as well. Alright, so that's going to do it. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for tuning in. And hopefully I'll see you in the next video. And until then, take care, stay safe, and so long for now.